Friday, so fuel filled up, Copenhagen in a can, black coffee in a cup, six string in a back 30-30.
Burley and dark air, forced air Burley, dark fired tobacco barns, portable curing frames, stripping rooms, hauling wagons. And we'll go right down here. Three-tier post rafter 32 foot.
So that PDF is available over at University.
There it is. This is plan 735-27C. 3-4 tier post pier rafter type, 48 feet wide, 26 beams, 1160 sticks per bent. So if we click on that, it's a PDF file we're going to download. And this is the blueprint that I used to build this barn. Notable differences between this blueprint and my barn. In this blueprint, they used 2x10s for cross members, and I used 2x12s. In this print, they put 5 feet vertical spacing for the tobacco to hang. Mine's 5'8". And in this print, they have a foot and 6 inches of post above the top 2x12 at the eave. I put 24 inches. So they're calling for 18, and I put 24 because I was advised by a farmer who built his plan exactly to this spec that it was difficult to put that top beam in because you kept hitting the roof. See, if your cleats don't line up with your block, your solution is to move the other end. If your cleats are going to fall short, lower the other end and it comes that way. If your cleats are way over too much, you raise the other end, that drags the cleats back, and that gives you enough cleats on the other end to hook it in place because you've only got 2 inches plus or minus. So you have to be money on the money. So in this print, they call for 18 inches of headroom right here at the eave, and I put 24 inches of mine. That little detail right there, that 1 foot 6 inch, mine's 2 feet.
And you were just up there.
And then, like I said, they're showing 5 feet for 5 foot tobacco, assuming.
Yeah.
I made mine 5'8". You saw my tobacco down there that was 5'10 plus. Now, here's another thing we talked about out in the field that I don't think made much sense. Do you see this loop of cable that's thrown over this 2x12?
Yeah.
And you see this extra beam here?
Yeah.
That's how you get your full capacity. I don't have any of those in there right now. Like, I have the loops. You'll see them in other places. But I've had a problem. Do you see a new 2x12 right there?
Yeah.
That's because I broke the old one. I put the loops on the old one, and I double loaded it, and it broke in half. Of course, we were exceeding the specifications for the barn. They're calling for 40 sticks of big tobacco and 50 sticks of small tobacco. We had 60 sticks of big tobacco on every beam.
Yeah, I remember that.
It was 7 foot tobacco, stalks that big around. Take a look at those rafters up here. There's a steel pipe 2 inch in diameter, and it's attached to 3 rafters. When we put the rafters on the barn, we put 3 hardwood rafters where that pipe is, and the other rafters between there and the next pipe are just poplar.
Yeah.
So all the stress and the weight gets put on that rafter.
Yeah, the 3 of them.
So there's a kicker 2x4 right beside that rafter.
Yeah.
And another one over here helps transfer some of that load to that 2x12. And that 2x12, they're all 3 tied together with another 2x6. So that we're not putting undue stress on any one member. We're pulling together.
And
it'll make some noise. It'll do some popping.
How much weight?
I don't think these things weigh but about 1,600. But with the Burley, like that field right there.
Yeah.
You could get 2,500 pounds, probably. We've got a 10 horsepower Kohler Magnum.
10 horses with a brand new coil.
It's attached to a small gear pump via a Lovejoy coupling. The small gear pump has its own tank with a filter. And that pressure is transmitted to an electric solenoid valve.
New battery.
So you got two electric solenoid valves here.
Yeah.
And then the 40-foot hydraulic hoses come out of those valves.
And where's the hydraulic reservoir?
This little tank right here.
Oh, I see. Got the hydraulic oil there. I see that.
It's almost like a wood splitter.
New fuel center.
Yeah. Stock fuel tank for this vintage Kohler engine is $300.
Brand new coil. I'd get you another 10 years out of it.
We got this fuel cell here from a repair shop, secondhand salvage unit for $20.
I reckon that I am, but there's things going on that make me mad to the core. I gotta work like a dog to make ends meet. There's crooked politicians and crime in the streets, and I'm madder than hell, and I ain't gonna take it no more. They tell our kids to just say no, then some panty waste judge lets a drug dealer go, slaps him on his wrist, and he turns him back out on the town. Well, if I had my way with people selling dope, I'd take a big tall tree and a short piece of rope. I'd hang them up high and let them swing till the sun goes down. Well, you know what's wrong with the world today? People done gone, put their Bibles away. They're living by the law of the jungle, not the law of the land. Well, the good book says it, so I know it's the truth. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. Better watch where you go. Remember where you've been. That's the way I see it. I'm a simple man. Yeah, I'm the kind of man wouldn't harm a mouse. But if I catch somebody breaking in my house, I got a 12-gauge shotgun waiting on the other side. So don't go pushing me against my will. I don't want to have to fight you, but I darn sure will. So if you don't want trouble, then you better just pass me on by. As far as I'm concerned, there ain't no excuse for the raping and the killing and the child abuse. And I got a way to put an end to all that mess. You just take them rascals out in the swamp, put them on their knees and tie them to a stump. Let the rattlers and the bugs and the alligators do the rest. Well, you know what's wrong with the world today? People done gone, put their Bibles away. They're living by the law of the jungle, not the law of the land. Yeah, the good book says it, so I know it's the truth. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. You better watch where you go. Remember where you've been. That's the way I see it. I'm a simple man. Watch where you go. Remember where you've been. That's the way I see it. I'm a simple man.